Now we'll move on to the next habit, that is tongue thrusting. So in tongue thrusting, yes, again, certain confusing things are there which you need to know. So basically, you have a simple tongue thrusting and a complex tongue thrusting. Then again, classification called a retained tongue thrusting. And this classification into simple, complex and retained is given by Moyers. Okay, so the first type is the simple tongue thrusting. So what do you mean by a simple tongue thrusting? Simple tongue thrusting means it is a normal tooth contact during swallow. And at the same time, in a complex tongue thrusting, what you see is that you see a tooth apart swallow. Because the tongue is coming in between, right? So you see a tooth apart swallow in a complex tongue thrusting. Now, in a simple tongue thrusting, you see a well-circumscribed open bite and a diffuse open bite is seen in a complex tongue thrusting. This is an important question for you. Like you'll get questions like which of the following comes under a complex tongue thrusting? Which of the following features do you see in a complex tongue thrusting? So this, so all these points are very important for you. Now, back to the topic. In simple tongue thrusting, you see good intercuspation of the teeth with the posterior occlusal fit. And in complex tongue thrusting, you see a poor occlusal fit and instability of the intercuspation. So whatever things are easier in simple, they will be complicated in a complex tongue thrusting. Now, the next point or the fourth point is the most frequently asked point or the most frequently the answer regarding, if you get a question from this, the most frequent answer will be the fourth point. So what is that? Is that in simple tongue thrusting, there will be contraction of your lips, mentalis muscles and mandibular elevators. And you see a hyperactive mentalis muscle in simple tongue thrusting. Okay. Now, at the same time, in complex tongue thrusting, there will be combined contraction of your lip and facial and mentalis muscles. There will be combined contraction of lip, facial and mentalis muscles, and there will be lack of contraction of your temporalis muscle. Okay, so this is the most important point that most of the MCQ question will pick. There will be lack of contraction of which muscle? That is temporalis muscle contraction will be absent in the complex tongue thrusting. Okay, now in simple tongue thrusting, the mandible is stabilized by the normal muscles of mastication. And in complex tongue thrusting, the mandible is stabilized by your facial muscles. Okay, it is not stabilized by the muscles of mastication. It is stabilized by your facial muscles. Can anyone tell me what are the muscles of mastication? Which all muscles were the muscles of mastication? Yes, temporalis, masseter, medial pterygoid and lateral pterygoid. Very good. These are the muscles of mastication. So temporalis is your masticatory muscle. So the lack of contraction of temporalis is seen in complex tongue thrusting. Because in complex tongue thrusting, the mandible is stabilized by your facial muscles. And at the same time in simple tongue thrusting, the mandible is stabilized by your muscles of mastication. Now, so in simple tongue thrusting, you don't see facial muscle contraction during swallowing. At the same time, facial muscle contraction during swallowing is seen in your complex tongue thrusting. Okay, so these are the main difference between a simple and complex tongue thrusting. So of this, the fourth point is the most important one. In the simple tongue thrusting, there is contraction of your lips, mentalis and mandibular elevators. At the same time, in complex tongue thrusting, there is combined contraction of your lips, facial and mentalis muscle. There is no contraction of the temporalis muscle in your complex tongue thrusting. Okay, now, what are the characteristics of mature swallow? The swallow patterns also comes along with your habit, a tongue thrusting habit. So again, mature swallow, infantile swallow, and all these swallow classification is given by Moyers. Okay, the classification of swallow is given by Moyers. And what do you mean by a mature swallow? So in a mature swallow, it means that your tooth is in occlusion. You see the picture that you can see that the tooth is in occlusion and the mandible is stabilized by the contraction of your mandibular elevators. That is how it should actually go, right? The mandible is stabilized by the contraction of the mandibular elevators. Now, then you have a tongue tip. You can see that the tongue tip is held against the palate above and behind the maxillary incisors. And there is minimal lip contraction. These are the characteristics of a mature swallow. So you can see that the teeth are in occlusion. The mandible is stabilized by the contraction of mandibular elevators. The tongue tip, this is the tongue tip, which is held against the palate above and behind your maxillary incisors. And you see minimal lip contraction. Now, the next thing is an infantile swallow. So infantile swallow means what is happening in infants. Whenever the infant is swallowing, you can see that the infant is using all the muscles available in the face, right? You can see that there is vigorous lip and cheek contraction. You can see vigorous lip and cheek contraction, and the jaws are apart, and you can see that the tongue is coming between their gum pad. Okay, in infantile swallow, you can see that the tongue is coming between your gum pad. And again, the mandible is stabilized by facial muscles and the interposed tongue. And usually, in the pattern of infantile swallow, it disappears with the eruption of the buccal teeth. Okay, so these are the characters of infantile swallow. So in infantile swallow, you see vigorous lip and cheek contraction. The jaws are apart, and you can see that the tongue is interposing between the gum pad. The mandible is stabilized by the facial muscles, and usually it disappears with the eruption of the buccal teeth. Now, next thing is a retained infantile swallow. So it is the persistence of infantile swallow even after the eruption of a permanent teeth. Okay, even after the eruption of the permanent teeth, if you see a persistent infantile swallow, you refer it to as a retained infantile swallow. So of all these swallow patterns, which type of swallow causes most complications or most amount of oral problems or malocclusion? The answer is retained infantile swallow. So the most problematic swallow pattern among all the swallow patterns which we have learned is retained infantile swallow. Okay, so that is it about the swallow patterns. Now we'll see again once more. Mature adult swallow means the tongue touches the anterior palate, a tight lip seal will be formed, and the mandible is stabilized by your muscles of mastication. And here in infantile swallow, you can see that the tongue is protruding between your gum pad and the lips are apart. There is no lip seal. The mandible is balanced by your muscles of facial expression or your facial muscles. Okay, usually this type of swallow mature once the tooth erupts and it comes into contact and when the child starts taking a solid food. Okay, so these are the two different types of swallow patterns. If you understand the basics of this, you can answer a lot of questions regarding the same. Right, now moving on to the diagnosis of tongue thrusting. So how do you diagnose tongue thrusting? This was an important MCQ. This is an important MCQ question for you. And this was asked during my NEET preparation, my NEET exam. So the first identification of how do you diagnose tongue thrusting? So the first examination is that what you do is that you place water beneath the patient's tongue tip and you ask the patient to swallow. Okay, you place water beneath the patient's tongue tip and you ask him to swallow. So normally what you see is that your mandible will rise, your mandibular elevators will work, your mandible will rise, the teeth are brought together and there is no contraction of the lips and facial muscles. Okay, but in tongue thrusting, there will be marked contraction of lips and facial muscle. Right? So this is how you diagnose tongue thrusting. This is one method for diagnosing tongue thrusting. So normally you'll see a mandibular elevators will be functioning. The mandible will rise. The teeth are brought together and there is no contraction of the lips and facial muscles. And in the case of tongue thrusting, you see a marked contraction of lips and facial muscles. Now, the second method is that you place hand over the temporalis muscle and you ask the child to swallow. So normally the temporalis will contract and the mandible is elevated, right? But in the case of tongue thrusting, you don't see temporalis muscle contraction. So that is how you diagnose tongue thrusting based on the temporalis muscle. Now, the next method is that you hold the lower lip of the child and you ask him to swallow. So normally, even if for a normal individual, the swallow can be completed, even if the lips are held apart. But in tongue thrusting, the patient cannot swallow because in tongue thrusting, the child needs the lips also for completion of the contraction of lips for the completion of swallow. So in the case of tongue thrusting, if you hold the lower lip and ask the patient to swallow, the patient will not be able to swallow. Okay, now regarding the treatment of tongue thrusting. So these were the methods, how do you diagnose tongue thrusting? And regarding the treatment aspects of tongue thrusting, you know, there are various myofunctional exercises in tongue thrusting. That is, you ask the child to place the tip of the tongue in the rugae area for 5 minutes and you ask the child to swallow. So these are all tongue training exercises. You are actually training the child the correct and proper position of the tongue during a swallow pattern. Okay, now the next myofunctional exercise is again an orthodontic elastic and a sugarless fruit drop exercise. You will ask the child to hold an orthodontic elastic against the rugae of the palate and try to complete the swallow. All these comes under your tongue training program, under the tongue training of the for the proper positioning of your tongue. Now, the next is a 4S exercise. So 4S exercise is used in the treatment of tongue thrusting. Again, it is a myofunctional exercise for the proper positioning of the tongue. 4S means there are 4S, right? So what are the 4S? One is spot by tongue, salivating, squeezing the spot and swallowing. So these are the 4S in myofunctional exercise, 4S exercise. So you spot, salivate, squeeze, swallow. Okay, spot, salivate, squeeze and swallow. That is 4S exercise in the tongue training of myofunctional exercises. Now, then you have appliances to guide the correct positioning of the tongue. So this is the picture of a tongue trainer. This is called a pre-orthodontic or tongue trainer. So you can see that there is a bead over here and also there are rakes like this. So what happens if the child is having a tongue twisting, will the child be able to, will the child get the pleasure from the habit? No. So that is why it is called a tongue trainer and you can actually instruct the child to roll the bead. So that bead is positioned in that place in the palate which your tongue should actually be during a swallow pattern. So again, this is the picture of a tongue trainer. Now, next is a Nance palatal arch appliance. So what you have learned about Nance palatal arch will be in the space maintenance, right? So in Nance palatal arch, you have an acrylic button. So this acrylic button can be used to guide the tongue in correct position. So a Nance palatal arch also comes in your treatment part of your tongue thrusting. And the other appliance like your bluegrass appliances, tongue guard, everything will be there. Everything is also a part of your tongue thrusting habit. Now, in mechanotherapy, you have palatal grip, like your fixed and removable grips. Then you have an oral screen, that is a modified version of oral screen called a double oral screen. So what do you mean by a double oral screen? Double oral screen means there are two shields, two screens are there. So this is the outer screen. And then there is a lingually an additional tongue shield is also there. So when you place a double oral screen inside the oral cavity, because of the tongue shield, the tongue thrusting will also be corrected. So this is this double oral screen, which is a modification of the normal oral screen, is there in the correction of your tongue thrusting.